The ability to live stream is an awesome way to connect with and grow your community in real time, and it's built right in to Mighty Networks. My name is Tom, and today I'm going to show you the simple steps to going live from directly within your Mighty Network. The community plan offers 2 hours of live streaming each month, while the business plan offers 4 hours of live streaming, and each one has one host, which is the person who's actually leading the stream from their device or their computer. The community plan will allow for up to 50 viewers at a time, while the business plan will allow for up to 100 viewers at a time. But if that's not enough for you, if you need more hours, if you want to have more attendees, if you want more storage, you can always get an engagement boost to increase those to meet the needs of your community. So now let's jump in and talk about exactly what it means to go live. As the name implies, it means that it's not pre-recorded. You're streaming directly in real time with your community, and this is an incredibly powerful tool. Live streaming has become incredibly popular in recent years, and now the ability to live stream from directly within your Mighty Network makes your community even more valuable for your members. And whether you're a streaming veteran or you're brand new to it, it is very simple. You can stream either from a computer or a mobile device. Both are very simple, and I'll show you how to do both. So let's start with how to stream from a computer. Right from within your Mighty Network, you can click the plus sign to share what's on your mind, and you will see a go live icon, or you can also click the plus sign to add a new post as you would normally, and you can also then go live right from here. Either way, it's the exact same thing. If you click on that, then you're gonna see the setup window for your live stream. You just wanna give your stream a name, and then you can select your camera and your microphone. You can use a built-in webcam and microphone, or you can connect an external camera and microphone. You can keep it as simple or as complex as you want. In this case, I will select the camera. I'll select a different camera. And then the microphone, I'm gonna be using my Rodecaster Pro because that's my favorite thing to use for audio. And then you have a few options right here. One is to record the live stream. And as it says right here, once the stream is over, you'll get notified when a recording is ready. And then you can also decide if you wanna notify your members that you're going live. That can be a great way to make sure people don't miss out on the stream. And then you just click go live. You're gonna see your preview window up here, and then you're gonna see just a couple loading messages to help you get into the right state of mind before you start your stream. And that's it. That quickly, I'm live in my Mighty Network right now. If people watch this, they might get a little confused. And this is what you'll see as the host when you're live. Right up here in this corner is the option to end the stream along with the duration of the stream, so you can keep track of if you're within your time limits. And then over here on this side is where you can see the chat and your participants. So right now I'm the only person in this stream. It's a very lonely place. And here is a chat. So if your members join and they want to say something, they can just add it to the chat right there and you can keep track of that. So even if your members aren't actively chatting, you can still see who's in the stream, and that can be really helpful to help you recalibrate on the fly to make sure the info that you're giving and the stream that you're creating is as relevant and useful to the members who are there as possible. And even though I am using my computer for the stream, our community members can join in from their phone, their mobile device, a computer. It doesn't matter what you're streaming on versus what they're watching on and participating on. And when I'm done with the stream, then I just click end live stream, and that's it. And going live from within the Mighty Networks app is just as simple. So whether you're on iOS, Android, a phone, a tablet, once you're in the Mighty Network app as a host, at the top, you'll see a go live option. If you tap on that, you're gonna then see kind of the same exact settings that we saw with the desktop. You can give your stream a name and then select your camera. A lot of phones have front cameras and back cameras. You can select either one. And of course you can also switch during your stream. I'm gonna select the front camera from now. Microphone, I'm just using the built-in microphone on my phone, but you could also connect an external one if you want. And same thing, you can choose to record the video, and you can also choose to notify your members that you're going live, and then you just press go live. Look at me here. You're gonna see a quick loading thing. You're gonna see a lot of the same messages that we saw earlier when we were going live through the desktop. Gotta take a deep breath. 3, 2, 1, and there we go. That's as long as it took for me to start to go live with a mobile device. Just like on the desktop, I can view different participants, and then I can also keep an eye on the chat right here from within my phone. And when I'm done, I just click end live video. And once your live stream recording is ready to go, you'll get a notification just like anything else. And from there, you can click on it, you can save it, you could delete it, or you can add it to a post and put it in one of your topics, and then community members can watch the replay, and you're all set. Of course, it's always up to you if you want to make the replay available for your members or not. That totally depends on the needs of your community. I definitely think that it's a valuable thing to do because by the very nature of a mighty network, you probably have members that are in different time zones, maybe even spread across the globe, and setting up a time when everyone can be on a stream at the same time can sometimes be difficult. And so by adding a replay, you're giving your members the opportunity to not only replay the stream, but to also continue to add comments and replies and kind of keep the conversation going even after the stream has ended. And I know that might seem simple, but that's literally all that's involved in going live from directly within your mighty network. If you haven't tried it out yet, I definitely recommend that you do. I think you'll have a lot of fun with it and your members will as well. And now that you know how to go live, check out this video here where I'll give you a few tips and tricks on how to create the best possible live stream for your Mighty Network community members.